fingers can't touch. You're not gone, just out of sight. You're here with me, wherever you are tonight. I am better now for who you were. You always found the truth in me. More patient than this world deserves. Everything a friend should be. If heaven is our final destination, the love we leave behind is our salvation. Hearts will break, we cry, we grieve, we die, we go, but never leave. We linger in the lives of those we love. We're flesh and bone and beams of light. A body breaks, a soul takes flight. Faith is left to heal what tears can't touch. You're not gone, just out of sight. You're here with me, wherever you are tonight.
Welcome in the name of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. We are gathered to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, to remember before God our sister Rhonda, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief. On behalf of the family, I extend a word of gratitude to each of you for your presence here today as you surround them with your love. Your love becomes a source of strength for them. So thank you for being here today and for continuing to support the family in the coming days and weeks and months ahead. Everything that you need for today's service is in your service folder. The music is recorded, so when the music is playing, just listen for the message. Prayerfully contemplate the beautiful gift of Rhonda's life and give God thanks for that. But there are places in the service where we ask you to participate. The thanksgiving for baptism and the prayer of the day in those places. I just invite you to do that to the glory of God today. Following the service, we will proceed to Oakland Cemetery for the committal service there, and following that, the family will return to the fellowship hall, where you again are invited to gather around the table with them and continue to both grieve and celebrate Rhonda's life. With that, I invite you to stand as you are able and turn towards the entrance of the sanctuary. All who are baptized into Christ have put on Christ. In her baptism, Rhonda was clothed with Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, she shall be clothed with glory. Eternal God, maker of heaven and earth, who formed us from the dust of the earth, who by your breath gave us life, we glorify you. We glorify you. Jesus Christ, the resurrection and the life, who suffered death for all humanity, who rose from the grave to open the way to eternal life, we praise you. We praise you. Holy Spirit, author and giver of life, the comforter of all who sorrow, our sure confidence and everlasting hope, we worship you. We worship you. To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Please remain standing for the processional.
Happen half the time, without reason, without rhyme. Lovely, sweet young woman, daughter, wife, and mother, makes no sense to me. I just have to believe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Loved one she left behind, just trying to survive and understand the why. Feeling so lost inside, anger shot straight at God, then asking for his love, empty with disbelief, just hoping that maybe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting, and I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. It's hard to say goodbye. Her picture in my mind will always be of times I'll cherish, and I won't cry, 'cause she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting, and I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about me.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. You may be seated. I encouraged and reminded the family last night before the visitation to remember, on days like this, remember to breathe deeply. Someone once said, we live as deeply as we breathe, and when we are anxious, when we're hurting, we tend to breathe rather shallowly. But breathing each breath reminds us that we are alive, reminds us that we still have the breath of life of God within us. So breathe deeply and let God bless you this day. We remember our sister Rhonda. Rhonda Sue Brock King was born just 63 years ago on March 12, 1961, in Cresco, Iowa. The daughter of Cohen and Norma Johnson Brock. She grew up in Forest City and attended Forest City High School with the class of 1979. She worked at Winnebago Industries for over 30 years and also worked at the Bungalow, the VIP Lounge, Mitchell's Bar and Grill, the Leland Bar and Grill, and also helped Jeff Mitchell in wherever his endeavors took him. She enjoyed waitressing, bartending, and the social interaction with everyone. Rhonda was an amazing woman who was always there for you with open arms. She was willing to go above and beyond to help others. She had a light about her that was infectious and could brighten up every room. During her 45 years of waitressing, she had a talent for remembering everyone's name and the ability to make you smile. The greeting, "Hi guys," will be greatly missed in this community. Rhonda loved gardening and making flower arrangements from her own flower bed, bowling in her younger years, hay rides, watching TV shows and movies, particularly ones with Kevin Costner. Rhonda had a passion for food and cooking for others. Everyone will remember her famous deviled eggs. She was a member of the Purple Peacocks, a group of ladies she loved dearly. She absolutely adored her kids, her grandchildren, and will be greatly missed by all who knew her. On Sunday, March 17th, 2024, at her home in Forest City, Rhonda died as a result of a tragic accident. She will be dearly missed. Rhonda is survived by her children, Allison Zroslik of Forest City, and Michael and Michaela Good of Leland. Her grandchildren, Mark, Hannah, Caleb, Brock, Cohen, and Whitney. Siblings, Trudy Folkerts, Ricky Brock, Jodine and Gary Bartleson, and Terrell and Tammy Brock, along with many nieces, nephews, and close friends. Rhonda was preceded in death by her parents, Cohen and Norma Brock, her son, Jeffrey Good, her brother, John Brock, and sister-in-law, Karen Brock, brother-in-law, Larry Folkerts, nephews, Brandon Brock and Darren Perkins, and the love of her life, Timothy Collins. May God add abundant blessings to our memory of Rhonda Sue Brock Kingland, King. And now we hear the song, "Jealous of the Angels."
Didn't know today would be our last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. In a world where heroes come and go, where God just took the only one I know. So must need another angel around the throne.
Please join me in the prayer of the day, a prayer giving God thanks for Rhonda's life. The words are printed in your service folder. Yeah, we've all got to clear our throats after that one, don't we? We pray, O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Rhonda. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We turn our hearts to God's word. This first reading from Isaiah 25 was chosen because of Rhonda's love for people and her deep pleasure that she had in feeding people and serving you. God, too, loves to feed, to bless, and to serve, and is planning a banquet, an amazing banquet for all who trust him. Isaiah 25. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food full of fats, of well-aged wines crystal clear. And God will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all people, the sheet that is spread over all nations. God will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of God's people will be taken away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God, we have waited for him, so that God would save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in God's salvation. The second reading is from 1 Thessalonians, and it's a word of encouragement to all who grieve, an encouragement to trust in God beyond our own vision. We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will at an unexpected moment descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. And from John chapter 3, For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in Jesus will not perish, but have eternal life. Amen. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. After meeting with some of you this past week, and learning about Rhonda's life, it seems that the theme of Rhonda's family of origin, the Brock family, might just be, expect it when you least expect it. Now, in Rhonda's case, that meant Brother Terrell scaring the living daylights out of her at every turn. Or it meant someone taking advantage of Rhonda's trusting nature. She was known for leaving her keys in her cars. And you stinkers, would go to her car while she was in a store or in a restaurant, and you'd move her car, leaving her to wonder where in the world she had left it. And if that wasn't enough, grandson Brock might climb into that same said car when she was in a store or a restaurant, hiding under a blanket once again to scare the heck out of Rhonda, out of Grandma, when she got in her car. Expect it when you least expect it. And Rhonda just had that bubbly, sort of naive personality that welcomed all such pranks. And she was so good-hearted about it. But this Sunday, March 17th, an unexpected fall has brought an end to Rhonda's life so unexpectedly, so tragically, after only 63 years of life. And we just want to protest. This isn't funny, God. This isn't fair. This is just wrong. A woman who worked so hard to care for her family, who rarely asked for anything, if ever, but who gave so much. This isn't right. In moments like this, we wonder about God. Where were you, God? Why did you let this happen? Couldn't you have just let her break another bone or two or three like all the other times that spared her life? The unexpected is fun and funny when we catch someone off guard, but this God just isn't funny at all. So we hurt. We find ourselves angry. Angry with God and angry with the situation, angry with the injustice of a life cut short. Those who knew Rhonda best knew that she herself faced times in life that brought unexpected tragedy when her son Jeffrey died, when the love of her life, Tim Collins, died. Expect it when you least expect it. This just isn't right. It's my understanding that Rhonda wept, that she grieved deeply, that she carried that hurt and that loss in her heart, but she didn't let it steal her joy, her love for people and her love for living. She didn't let it steal her light. A light that she shared with many of you. In Lamentations chapter 3, we hear the word of God that says, sorrow may last for the night, but joy comes in the morning. It seems to me that that was Rhonda. Nowhere in Scripture does God promise that life will be easy or free of tragedy. But God everywhere in Scripture promises to be with us through it, to hold on to us, to keep us safe in life and in death, to give us a future beyond this world. Psalm 23, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. In her baptism, God said to Rhonda, you are my beloved daughter, and I will love you forever, and I will give you life in this world and the next. And God is faithful. We can trust that in God's hands, this is not the end for Rhonda, but a new beginning. Let me say that again. We can trust that in God's hands, this is not the end for Rhonda, but a new beginning. Seriously. God loves Rhonda, and Rhonda loves you. She worked hard for 30 plus years at Winnebago, always having one or two other jobs, because she loves you. She did that to care for her children and her grandchildren because she loves you. She blessed you and spoiled you, especially you grandchildren, for by making your favorites, your cutout cookies and your finger jello and your ham, and whatever you wanted, because she loved you. She couldn't say no. At Christmas, she asked for nothing and gave everything because she loves you. She'd brag about her grandkids, whether it's working beside you at the restaurant or watching you and supporting you in all of your activities because she loves you. She helped organize the Chasing the Sun Memorial Run and the Brock Family Run motorcycle rides because she loved. And she wanted to remember and honor those who have gone before. She waitressed for 45 years. Who in the world was rubbing her feet at night? 45 years because she loved. She loved people and she loved making them happy, you happy. She let her light brighten your world because she knew how to love unselfishly. She danced. She danced to show you how to love, how to live, how to be alive even when the unexpected happened. Now, Brother Ricky told me that he called her Rhonda Ruru. And I didn't ask why. It sounds like she had multiple nicknames, but Ricky called her Rhonda Ruru, and I'm just going to guess that it's because Rhonda was a great cheerleader. Not only literally, but a great cheerleader for her siblings and for her children and grandchildren, for those who were down and out, because she knew how to love. Now, Rhonda's name, her name means, there are a couple different definitions, and I think they're both fitting. The first is good spear. Rhonda had a personality and a love that could pierce your heart. It could let you experience love and life as she experienced it. The other definition for her name is noisy. I'm told that she had a voice that carried, and she knew how to use it for good. Demo derbies, cheering you on, louder than the cars on the track. She could stand between two grown men who were acting like adolescents and send them to their corners because she had a voice and she knew how to use it, because she loved, because she was strong. Because she cared. Rhonda was pretty good at catching you off guard too, I think. Making you laugh, making you scratch your head, making you wonder where in the world her capacity to love came from. With this latest unexpected twist that has taken her from you, it's your turn to cry. It's your turn to cry through the night and to muster up your courage to face each new day, not letting the unexpected tragedy of death steal your joy, your hope, your laughter, your love, and your willingness and ability to dance. Tomorrow in the church is Palm Sunday, the day that we celebrate Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, the beginning of Holy Week. It's a day when we hear shouts of Hosanna to the Son of David, Hosanna to the King. And we will see Jesus wash his disciples' feet and send them out to love and serve on Maundy Thursday. And on Good Friday, those shouts of praise and blessing will turn to unexpected and ugly shouts of crucify him, crucify him. And Jesus will be put to death on Good Friday. This is your Good Friday. the day of death. But Sunday is coming, my friends. The unexpected of God is coming. For on the third day, Jesus will rise. Jesus will defeat death. Jesus will make a way where there is no way. He will make a way through death into new life. And the unexpected will come, will become our new reality. From death to life in God's kingdom, a place at God's eternal and abundant banquet of life. Dear friends, weep this night. Weep for Rhonda. The sting of Friday's death hurts. But remember, the unexpected is coming. Easter is coming. Life eternal is coming for Rhonda, for you and for me, for all sinners redeemed by the blood of Jesus. So friends, get ready. Get ready to dance. Get ready to celebrate our God and the life that only God can give. You raise me up, Josh Groban. invite you to stand as you're able for our prayers. Each petition will end with God of mercy, and I invite you to respond. Hear our prayer. Almighty God, you are our hope. Keep us in faith and bring us through the grave and gate of death to resurrection and joyful reunion in heaven. God of mercy, hear our prayer. You are our peace. Cleanse us from sin. Lead us by your Holy Spirit and help us to walk by faith all the days you give us. God of mercy, you are our healer. Watch over those who suffer and all who love them and their caregivers. God of mercy, hear our prayer. You are our light in darkness. Give courage and faith to those who are bereaved, that they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the comfort and of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. God of mercy, help us in the midst of things we cannot understand to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of life everlasting. God of mercy, you are our comfort. Heal the brokenhearted and bind up the wounds of your children. Strengthen us in our weakness. Calm our troubled spirits. Dispel our doubts and fears. In Christ rising from the dead, you conquered death and opened the gates of everlasting life. Renew our trust in you, that by the power of your love, we shall one day be brought together again with our sister Rhonda. Grant this, we pray, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us commend Rhonda to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your child, Rhonda Sue. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Let us go forth in peace in the name of Christ. Amen. Before our sending song, let us pray together the table prayer that's printed in your service folder. We'll speak this: be present at our table, Lord. Be here and everywhere adored. These mercies bless and grant that we may strengthen for thy service be.
We all drink to forget, some of us more than most. When reality gets too real, and the fires of hell too. But I'm here to let you know that you can make it through if you believe that someone is watching over you. And call it an angel, call it a muse, and call it karma that you got coming to you. What's the difference? What's in it? Soul.
Did she have to go so young? I just don't know why things happen half the time, without reason, without rhyme. Lovely, sweet young woman, daughter, wife, and mother, makes no sense to me. I just have to believe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Loved ones she left behind, just trying to survive and understand the why, feeling so lost inside. Anger shot straight at God, then asking for his love, empty with disbelief, just hoping that maybe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. It's hard to say goodbye. Her picture in my mind will always be of times I'll cherish, and I won't cry, 'cause she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and paths where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting, and I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. Don't.